Welcome to the Attunity Oracle Change Data Capture for SSIS demo. My name is Richard Thomas, and today we're going to see an affordable solution for real-time Oracle data integration using replication and change data capture. What we're going to see today is a minimal impact log-based Oracle replication that allows us to look at the Oracle logs and efficiently realize what changes have taken place based on specific databases and tables, and using an available ETL tool from Microsoft that comes with SQL Server, known as SQL Server Integration Services. We're going to use that tool to then target our database to SQL Server. This is just one of many different solutions that Attunity provides in change data capture. What we're going to see now is a source Oracle database. We're going to go ahead and use wizards that have been established in the Visual Studio Designer for building integration services, and we're going to generate a CDC service. We're going to stage the information. We're going to actually have packages that we generate that actually puts and deposits the changes that occur in Oracle into a SQL Server database. Within that package generation, we're going to see full CDC configuration set up. Along with the wizard, we'll also then generate packages that do a full load of the Oracle tables that we've identified, along with a package to do change data capture. So let's take a look at the demonstration. So first step, let's go over to the Oracle database. So I got a little object browser up there, and one of the two tables we're going to work on is regions. We're going to actually add rows. So I'm going to go out and run Oracle scripts. Today I just have four rows in there, and I'm going to just start generating rows into the Oracle database and then see those automatically through the packages that we run in SSIS delivered into SQL Server. The SQL Server database then is a very similar looking database with a regions table, country table, and what we've done is I've gone ahead and we have them in sync at this point. I've got four rows in each. And lastly, we go into the tool itself to actually create this. So the first thing I need to do is I go through, and within the package, within the solution, I'm going to generate my packages and my CDC configuration services. So first the CDC services. I establish the target database, the Oracle target database, I have an account. I test my environment and make sure I have the minimum requirements to accomplish this, such as the connection is right, I've got the appropriate privileges, supplemental logging has been turned on, that we're capable of achieving this. The next step I do is establish the service port that I'm going to run the change data capture service in within the Windows box. I'm going to identify the tables, country and region in this case, from the Oracle database that I'd like to work with. We auto-generate the scripts that you're going to need to apply to the Oracle database to allow this to happen. And at this point, I'm going to go ahead and deploy. And what we're doing is we're saving the information, and we're actually generating Windows services that are going to go out and read the information out of the Oracle LogMiner. I'm going to go ahead and activate that service so it's up and running for us so we can actually take advantage of this. So we're actually working with a live Oracle and SQL Server database. We're inside the tool set. And now the second step is to go out and actually generate a CDC package. So the second step is to then establish our target database, followed by which table mappings that I want. So as we said, we want it from Oracle region and countries. We're going to target those region and countries to the SQL Server database. We've established the primary key that's required for SQL Server as a target. And then we're going to go ahead and generate the packages. And we're going to give them a use default. We could have created any sort of name that we wanted to use. And once we do that, what type of package we want, the CDC package, the full load package. And we create those. Once they're created and they're finished, we can go over here and go to the full load, run the full load. And what that's going to do is take all of the rows from regions and from countries and bulk load them from the Oracle to the SQL Server target database. That establishes, that gives us a baseline, and actually we save where we were within the Oracle database. Now the next step is actually to go and run change data capture package. Now this is going to be a data flow that's actually working with and looking at the log miner. This service has established that. That information is made available then to the SSIS package. And what we'll now do is go over here, and I have a PL SQL script that I'm going to go ahead and put some changes in there. So let's run that loop. Let's start putting some information. So I'm doing both updates and inserts. We're going to focus on the inserts, but we're going to get this information going. We're going to get it flowing through. Let's go ahead and let a few iterations happen. So we're going to get about 20 or 30 rows out there. Then I'm going to go back into SSIS and actually run the package to move the information over into the target SQL Server database. So we have the package open, and the next step is to run the package. And as we're going to see, we're going to be moving a bunch of updates through, which are in countries, and then we're going to establish changes over in region. So we see we've moved over 50 rows in the region, and we've got 50 rows of updates into the country. If we go back into our SQL Server database and rerun the query for the regions table, we will now see all that information has been replicated from Oracle into our target SQL Server database using the SSIS tool and the Attunity wizards to generate all of this with the services. To recap this, what we've demonstrated is an affordable, efficient, real-time data integration, in this case for Oracle, but we're not limited to that. We do this for SQL Server, DB2, and many other databases. We leverage the value of what we have invested in this case, Microsoft SQL Server Integration Services, but this technology is not limited to that. We work with many other ETL tools, and it's real-time delivery, efficient integration, and it was a very affordable and effective, fast way to accomplish that. To find out more about Attunity, please visit our website at www.attunity.com. Again, my name is Richard Thomas, and my email is below, and we've embedded a link into this video that will allow you to see a more in-depth demonstration of the product. Thank you for taking time today to watch this demonstration of the Attunity product.